shoot us.
Thank you.
Répète et en bas, que ça se commence.
Voto.
Front row. Répète du front, que ça se commence.
Voto.
Appelez-le.
Passe non moment. Why we going for expansion?
God praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
President.
Comrade Victor. Comrade Victor.
Thank you.
appreciate you.
Extra mind in facing challenges.
What do we mean by extra mind? Extra mind is simply defined as addition or extraordinary or unusual. Anyhow, your dictionary may give it to you. But for today, then we'll talk about a challenge. The challenge is an opponent. Somebody opposing you is a challenge. So we are going to see from the book of 1 Samuel chapter 17. It's a familiar story. So 1 Samuel chapter 17 from verse 4. Because of time, when you jot it down from that verse 4 to the last verse, then you see all the whole story about the challenges of life. May God help us in Jesus' name. A time came in the life of the children of Israel during the reign of King Saul, the Benjamite. The Bible says that a time came that the Philistines waged war against the Israelites. And King Saul, the Bible describes him in his own day, he was also huge and tall. He was a man well to do, and he was well trained in military form. But something came that challenged him. In the whole history of life, there is no place that Bible says that King Saul went for war and hid. No. But it was only in that book of 1 Samuel chapter 17 that the Bible made us to understand that he suffered challenge with his men and he ran to his saints. So the Bible said in the book of 1 Samuel chapter 17 from verse 4, he said that challenges is saying that we oppose man in his life as we are now today. The whole wide world is facing through challenges of hell called colonial virus. And every man, every woman, both the president, both the World Health Organization have run to his own hidden place for safety. Now, who shall we run unto? But the Bible says in the book of Psalm chapter 127, verse 1, says that except God build the city, that the builder or the keeper of the city are wasting their time. My brothers and sisters, what are those challenges that have surfaced to oppose your life, that have surfaced to oppose your spiritual life, or your material life, your moral life, your social life, as a human being? In this time around, the only thing that you could do is to trust and lay your confidence on God. Somebody like David was the only man that when the people of Israel were passing through these challenges of their opponent in war, the Bible said, for over 40 days, as they looked out to that mountain for the battle, every day the Philistines will come up and say, so, give me one man. I need a man that will fight me. That if that man can be able to fight me and kill me, glory be to your God, that we will be your subject. But if I fight him and kill him, glory be to my God, that you people will be our subject. But the Bible says for over 40 days, Saul could not produce a man that can be able to immerse this uncircumcised Philippians. In the life of God, you know, when God is looking at man, anytime man have walked and get tired, God surfaces. And then came that after that 40 days, Jesse being the father of David, because already he had deposited three of his sons that they should go. Also in that part, they were also there at the camp. They could not do anything. These men were a trained soldier, a trained man, just as we are here. Most of us may be a medical help aspect or the other, but at the stage of the world now, nobody has any solution. So the only solution in life today is what? God. It is only God that has the answer for today's problem. May God help us in Jesus' name. Challenges may arise in every area of your life. The challenge that I, David, may pass through may not be the one that may come in your way. But my advice today to you all is that whenever the challenges arose, that you should remember God. When you remember him alone will wipe away your tears and give you what? Victory. Because in him, victory is what? Assured. May God help us in Jesus' name. My brothers and sisters, once again, today, as you have just witnessed what has happened here, some of us may say that the religious duty or the do that. Rangers, as it was being originated in America, it was being formed for the role like this to be filled. The Bible said in the history of it, it said that the church in America were passing through likeness of men and the boys. And they formed it. And they formed it for what to happen? To win souls. And because of it, when they formed it, things began to happen. But today, the passion of the rangers or the boy win soul have died. Brethren, please, I beg you for today, that after today, may we revive ourselves, that we will have the passion for soul winning in Jesus' name. Amen. What the church is passing through today is that they are passing through the lack of passion for soul winning. That is one of the challenges in the church today. One of the challenges in the church today is the lack of passion for soul winning. Both the boys, both the young men, both the women, both the young women, of passion for soul winning. But I pray that God may revive us again in Jesus' name. Bow down your head, let's pray.
Our Father, behold your words, your people have heard. I speak, O God, and you help us in all challenges that come to our ways. Through this word, O God, comfort and make us to be strong. Father, we cover our life in the blood of Jesus. Bless this word and bless your servant. Father, something has gone out from him, and I know you are there to implement. Father, bless him and show him mercy. Thank you for blessing your people. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
We have a question for the mother. Thank you for being with us.